What's going on, Raider Nation? What's going on, football fans? Before I get into this video and say what I got to say about the Las Vegas Raiders, I want to thank everybody for coming through both streams on this doubleheader between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Pittsburgh Steelers, which the Raiders lose 13-10. And shout out for everybody for coming to the Dallas Cowboys and the Philadelphia Eagles game, which was the better game, when the Cowboys beat the Eagles 40-34. The Raiders lose. Simple as that. The Raiders lose. Are we not surprised? Are we still surprised? Because we shouldn't be. This offense was stagnant again. Derek Carr threw three picks. And this defense could hold up to as long as they could. This defense played good tonight. They did. Y'all can discredit them because of that last drive. But this defense got us turnovers. This defense got some loss of yards. This defense did whatever they could to get the ball back to this offense. And the offense has not done nothing but be stagnant and not care what this defense has done for them. Derek Carr, I called you out in my last video. I did. I called you out because you need to play better. And I understand that you had the narrative that you're not great under 32-degree weather. You don't win games under, matter of fact, you never won a game under 32-degree weather. You could have changed that narrative tonight. But the narrative shows that you just not good enough to play in cold weather. Simple as that. We have a leading rusher in Josh Jacobs. We have Hunter Renfrow. We have Waller. We have Davante Adams. And his offense only allowed to score 10 points. Unacceptable. But this is who we are. This is who we are. And I want to say this to a lot of Raider fans and Raider content creators. It's not a conspiracy that we lost. It's not rigged that we lost. I'm tired of hearing that the Raiders got cheated in this game. They didn't. Where was the cheat at? Where was the rig at? Oh, because it was the 50th anniversary of the Immaculate Reception and Franco Harris passed away before that. God bless his soul. But that's no excuse to make it seem like this is why the Raiders lost. The Raiders lost because the Raiders lost. Simple as that. We go out and buy this merch. We go out and do this and do that. And wear this Raiders gear. For what? To say it's rigged? No, I'm not going to say that. I'm not going to make no excuses for how we lost this game. I'm not going to make no excuses that even though we won the game last week, we did not deserve to win that game last week. We just didn't. We didn't deserve to win most of the games that we played. But let's make this clear. In the last seven games that we played, we were up in the fourth quarter and we lost all seven. We lost all seven, ladies and gentlemen. So how is it rigged? How is the fact that we keep getting cheated? How is the fact that the refs don't like us? How many excuses are we going to keep making for this football team that we're just not good enough? Yes, we can put the blame all on Josh McDaniels as you want with the play calling. But at the end of the day, you still have 22 players, 11 on offense and 11 on defense that still have to execute. No matter what the call is, but even though we might not like the play call, but the players still have to go out there and execute the play call. And Derek Carr didn't do that tonight. This offense didn't do it tonight. That's why I'm not talking bad about the defense, because the defense did whatever they could to get that ball back to the offense, and the offense just stood them high and dry. Simple as that. Stop making excuses for this Las Vegas Raiders football team. That's all I'm asking y'all, man. This is who we are. Until we make some changes. And people might say, oh, Derek Carr, oh, we got to get rid of him. We're not just one quarterback away. Do we need a quarterback? Yes. But are we one quarterback away? No. We still have to get an offensive line. We still got to get depth on the defense. We all know that Nate Hobbs is not an outside corner. He's a slot. No Rock Ya-Sin. No Anthony Everett. We don't have no outside corners. But this defense played up to par to a point to help this offense get where they need to be. But y'all want to blame the defense for the touchdown? After all them times we gave the football back to the offense? No. It's no excuse that the Raiders lost this game. It's no excuse. I don't care if you say it's a conspiracy. I don't care if you say it's rigged. I don't care if you say whatever. But it definitely wasn't rigged, and it definitely wasn't a conspiracy. It wasn't a conspiracy that we won yesterday. Last week. Come on, y'all. Y'all got to be realistic with yourselves. At the end of the day, the Raiders lost this game 13-10. No points in the second half. None. So how is this rigged? If we can't score points in the second half in the seven games that we lost. Let's just keep it real. Let's keep it real, Raider Nation. Stop faking the funk on these YouTube channels. This is who we are. This is exactly who we are. If you like the content. If you want to subscribe to hear some more content like this, subscribe to the channel. Until then, I'll see you on the next live stream or in the next video, man. Spotlight Football Talk. I'm out. Raiders suck. Season's over. We out of here.